I was born in Togo, raised in Togo. For me to be able to wear the shirt to represent my country, there is nothing better than that. So for me, it's very important to play on. I have been playing now since I was since I was 18 to today, and I'm captain of my national team today. So it was a long journey, which I'm still on the road. Keep going, you know, it's not easy, but you know, there's a lot of up and down, but I have managed and I have found a way to keep my mental going, my spirit going, and for me there's nothing better than being able to say I have represented my country when I have a chance to do it. So for me it's beautiful, it's wonderful. London for me is international, it's an international city, because you got everyone, Africans, black Americans, Indonesians, Chinese, you got everyone in London. That's the beauty of London.
You left Togo to come to France at quite a young age. Was it 15?
Yeah, I was.
Yeah, yeah. What was that like coming over to France to play football at such a young age?
It was hard, but you know, I told myself, listen, this is your chance, this is your opportunity. You have to grab it and embrace it. And to today, there's no regret anymore. I became who I became because I put the work towards it. And yeah, trust me, living Togo at the age of 15. It was not easy at all, because you have to leave your best friends, you have to leave your culture, you have to leave whatever you love doing most and come to a place where you don't have an idea of where you're going. Because when I was first moving to France, I never have any idea of where I was going, how it's going to be like, is it going to be nice? And trust me, it was not easy. It was very, very hard. The food was not the same. The weather, forget about it, because I was in mess. It was freezing, like freezing cold. From Togo, 37 degrees to a town where it's -5, -6. It's incredible for me. So yeah, the difference was huge, but it was not easy. But that's why I have to tell everyone, to get what you want, you have to go through a lot of difficult moments, but you have to go through it. You will fall down. There will be a lot of time you have to fall down, but you have to get ready to stand up again and keep moving. For me, that's the key.
I mean, you've played with players from all over the world. I mean, at Tottenham, you've got teammates from different countries. Do you see a value in that, in people from other countries playing together?
Of course, you learn through all those things, isn't it? Because sometimes I just ask Nabil what they love to eat in Algeria, and he tell me couscous or rice, and yeah, I have played with everyone. From Argentina to South Africa, to Belgium. Yeah, play with a lot of players. So you learn through everyone's culture, because whether you like it or not, you have to ask, it's your teammate. You're 24/7 with the guy. So no matter what, you have to ask him one silly question, which we call silly, but at the end of the day, you learn something from their country. And you can see the way everyone dresses is different. People dress in a different way. You dress upon where you come from. Because me, I got a lot of African fabrics that, because now the weather's getting good, which I will be wearing every day, because I'm from Africa and I'm proud being African. And you see some Arabian people, they wear like their long dress because they just live from there and they're proud of that. And for me, it's beautiful to play among all this. I play with a lot of people from Belgium, Moussa Dembele, Ivory Coast, Kolo Touré. So for me, it's beautiful to learn all different culture. At the end of the day, it's not even only in the football wise. For me, it's in the worldwide. Like, wherever you are, you have to respect your brother or sister, because we, at the end of the day, we are all the same. We are all human beings, and we think the same way. Obviously, you will think smarter than me, you will be quicker than me, you will be more intelligent than me. But at the end of the day, we are all human beings. You came out from woman. I came out from woman. So, you know, we have to have that. For me, it's very important to have that mutual respect towards each other. And I think that's what is getting wrong today. People are forgetting who they are or where they come from. At the end of the day, you can be billionaire, you can be whoever you are, you can be as poor as you want, you are a human being. I'm a human being.
Unfortunately, Adi, there's been a fair few incidences of racism within football, not just in this country, but abroad as well. Do you think that the game has made progress, though, in tackling racism within football?
I'm happy how things are going on now. Obviously, because you can see a lot of footballers are complaining, and you can see a lot of fans are joining in, which is for me, which is great to see, which means everyone is aware of this kick out racism in football. show it the red card. I think it's very important. We have to. So for me, for me being here today to support this charity is a beautiful thing I can never do. Because at the end of the day, as I will always say, we are all human beings, no matter who you are. Either you're black or white, you wake up in the morning, you brush your teeth the same way as I would do.
So the key is speaking out. So for players, what advice would you give to a young person at school who may be watching you now and may be suffering from racism or bullying? What would you advise them to do?
I know how hard it can be, but at the end of the day, it can never bring you down. No matter your color. But what I can tell them to do is to talk. The more you talk about it, more it's out of your system. And I think for me, it's very important. Whoever is going through these things in school or in work or whatever, talk with your best friend, talk with the teacher, talk with the headmaster. Somebody will definitely listen to you. And that will make a big change. Because they said, whenever you said it out, you are free. And your body, your spirit is free. And for me, it's very important to talk about it. And I think a lot of people, as I said earlier on, a lot of people are talking about it. And for me, that's the key. Show racism the red card. Nyana carton rouge racism. Now they told the football me.